There is no government that's going to commit or be able to honor a commitment to reduce rates from where they are now. It's just a fact of life.
Well, there you heard it. The Ontario government is promising that power will continue to cost more year after year, every year, to pay for their costly wind turbine schemes. But wait, just this week, in preparation for the next election, Ontario's Liberals say they now plan to make electricity bills cheaper. Could this be a trick? And will Ontario voters fall for it? Well, Sun News contributor Lori Goldstein joins us with more. Lori, great to see you again.
You too.
We know the power is going up in Ontario to pay for the Green Energy Act. So what's this news I hear in this pre-election mode that power bills are going to dip down? What's that all about?
Well, it's not true. What they're going to do is some accounting smoke and mirrors. When the original Ontario Hydro was privatized, it had a huge stranded debt. And the Ontario Tory government at that time put $7.8 billion of that money into an account like it's owing that we had to pay for. And so ever since 1998, to pay $7.8 billion, we've all been paying about $560 a month on our bills, okay, right? The Auditor General noticed 10 years later, he went, well, wait a minute. You said the debt was $7.8 billion, but reading your numbers, you've already collected more than $8 billion. Hmm. Why isn't the debt retired?
Yeah, good idea.
And the Liberals went, blah, blah, blah. By 2013, they had collected $10.8 billion, and yet they said they still had to pay $3.9 billion. Makes no logical sense. If you pay over $10 billion on a $7.8 billion debt, how can you have... But anyway, this has become a huge issue for them. People see that debt retirement,
yeah,
and they get angry. So
yeah,
now the Liberals say in their generosity, we are eliminating... Yeah. The debt retirement charge. But here's the trick. They're eliminating it on January 1st, 2016. On December 31st, the day before,
yeah,
what will end is the Ontario Clean Energy Benefit, which is money that they said, well, look, all this wind turbine, it's costing a lot of money, so we're going to help you. Upshot is, on January 1st, 2016, when they eliminate the debt retirement charge,
yeah,
your bill will go up anywhere from $120, $90 to $120 a year. Why? Because they're eliminating the clean energy benefit subsidy,
yeah,
right, which is worth about $190 a year to the average person, and they're going to eliminate this charge. But the charge is only $67 to $100.
Yeah.
So, folks, what they've announced today is on January 1st, 2016, because we really can't add, it's going to cost you about $100 more a month at least on your hydro bill.
Unbelievable.
That's what this... This today is all, I've never seen a government engage in more cynical,
yeah,
politics, smoke and mirrors,
yeah,
nonsense.
Yeah.
And the whole point is, you should have eliminated the debt retirement charge. You should have done that like 4 years ago.
Yeah, and the fact that they're kicking the can down to January 2016 tells you that they're just trying to wring those last drops out of it.
Now, the progressive conservatives say that why that number stayed so high was that they actually started borrowing against the debt.
I have no doubt.
Yeah.
Now, let me show you a little chart we put together comparing Ontario's existing power prices with those of nearby competitors. I mean, 13.5 cents a kilowatt hour effective May 1st. Compare that to Illinois, 8.74. I mean... It's substantially lower. Even Michigan, Ohio, North Dakota, and at the beginning of this little segment, Lori, I played you a clip from Bob Chiarelli saying no government can say they're reducing power prices.
Mm-hmm.
Well, all those American ones are. You know why? Because of fracking. Because it's lowered the cost of natural gas so much that all those American power plants are burning super cheap, clean natural gas. Their power prices are going down. The only reason why Ontario's are going up is because we're buying wind turbines instead of cheap, clean natural gas.
And we know from Mr. Chiarelli that our rates are going to go up 42% over the next 5 years. And we know from the Auditor General that over half of that is because of this ridiculous gamble they did with green energy. Look, and the practical thing of those rates is that we've lost 300,000 manufacturing jobs,
exactly,
in Ontario since the Liberals came to power. Now, what the Liberals are saying that is true is that, no, the rates aren't going to go down. And the reasons the rates aren't going to go down is a series of governments of all political stripes didn't do the repair and expansion of the grid that we need. So that's fair. They have to invest money into...
Yeah, I mean, how many brownouts and blackouts have there been in Toronto in the last 6 months?
Yeah.
My house alone has been hit twice.
Well, part of the reason is that they canceled the two gas plants in Oakville and Mississauga.
Yeah.
They actually needed those plants.
Yeah,
because
no doubt.
There's a lack of power there, and that's why when there's a brownout or a blackout in Toronto, one of the first areas to go is Western Toronto. But what they won't admit, what is behind all this, is that they could have done what they wanted to do, which was to eliminate coal-fired electricity,
yeah,
which is the most polluting kind, with nuclear and natural gas. Yeah. In fact, that's what they did. But the mistake they made is that they're pouring billions of dollars into wind turbines and solar, mainly wind.
Yeah.
And Ezra, more and more of this is coming on.
Yeah.
Like the amount of those contracts isn't going down.
Yeah.
They're coming up. And the liberals have nowhere. We don't need that power. Why don't we need that power? Because 300,000 manufacturing jobs have gone.
Yeah.
Manufacturers are closed. We need less electricity.
Yeah. You know, it's not just that. And we're almost out of time. But I used to on this show go at any random moment to the Ontario Wind Energy website that has a real-time percentage of wind turbines that are actually generating power.
Yeah.
It was often 5 or 10%. That is 90 or 95% of those wind turbines, we were paying for them, but we weren't actually getting any power. Since I started showing that on this website, they've changed their website so it is no longer easy to find out just how inefficient those wind turbines are.
Here's a simple way to do it. It doesn't matter how they do those things. Wind power right now provides maybe 3% of our electricity, right? Nuclear, 56%, right? Coal was 20%, and now it's zero.
Yeah.
Well, how could you cut down 20% of the electricity supply with only 3% of wind? None of that is happening.
It's the same math. It's why this province is in debt more than California.
They use nuclear gas, nuclear natural gas. That's how they did it. The rest is smoke and mirrors.
We've got to get you back on. It's great to see you, Lori.
You
Thanks
too.
For being here.